Dear students, today we will be dealing with aldol condensation under these following headings: introduction, mechanism, stereochemistry, regiochemistry, applications and limitations. Aldol condensation dates back to 1869 when it was put forward by Alexander Borodin and simultaneously by Charles Woods in the year 1872. It's a typical reaction of aldehydes having hydrogen in the alpha position to the carbonyl group and is also given by ketones in the presence of a base. Now let's see the mechanism of this reaction. Mechanism is a simple mechanism. That is, this is the aldehyde, acetaldehyde in the presence of a base will give us this type of a aldol, which by eliminating water when heated will lead to this unsaturated carbonyl compound. So first of all, in the first step, the base will attack this alpha carbon to give us this carbene ion, this and water. This carbene ion will then attack this carbonyl carbon, carbon positive, to give us this product, this condensed product, which will further react with water, since this is oxygen negative, so this will react with water and therefore we will get this aldol. Now this aldol will further undergo reaction with this base hydroxide, whereas alpha beta elimination will occur, alpha hydrogen from here leaving the electron pair. So simultaneously OH negative from the beta carbon, leading to the formation of this unsaturated compound. Finally, this is water is formed. Now this is alpha, this is beta, OH is eliminated and we get this type of an unsaturated carbonyl compound and the base is regenerated. So after the mechanism, let's come to the important aspects, because most of us are familiar with this condensation reaction. The stereochemistry, one can read more on it about the current progress in the asymmetric aldol addition reactions by Palomo et al. In Chemical Society Reviews, year 2004. So, current progress in asymmetric aldol addition reactions. Now, first of all, as far as the stereochemistry is concerned, let's deal with diastereoselectivity in this type of a condensation reaction. Now, diastereoselectivity implies that we are getting a pair of diastereoisomers. And from those diastereoisomers, how do we select one of them? So, as the reaction goes, this is CH3CH2COR. In the first step, in the presence of a base, the base will withdraw a hydrogen ion from here. So we will be getting this carbene ion and oxygen negative. So this will be changed into the enolate and the enolate is trapped in the form of trimethylsilyl ether. Now this enolate can be either E or Z. I have put the priorities here, as we can see, oxygen 1, alkyl 2, then this methyl 1, hydrogen 2. So as we can see here, similar groups, priority groups on the same side. So this is the Z enolate, whereas from the same carbonyl compound, this enolate is the E enolate, as groups having the same priority are on opposite sides of the double bond. So this is Z enolate and this is E enolate. The Z and the E form, which are formed from this carbonyl compound, which has an alpha hydrogen, which is abstracted by means of a base. These two, Z and E, these two enolates can then further be purified by chromatographic techniques. They can be separated and they can be purified by using chromatographic techniques. Now, out of these two, which one will predominate? Or which one can be made to be the major product? That is known as directed aldol condensation. Why directed? Now we are using certain techniques. By way of those techniques, we will be able to form one as the major. And what is the technique that we use? Rather than using trimethylsilyl, the heavier, in fact shorter, it can't say heavier, but shorter, boron is shorter. So we are using here the dialkyl borate of this compound, or this rather we can say enolate. Now this enolate which we have got here, as we can see, is the Z enolate, because similar priority groups are on the same side. And this Z enolate is the preferred enolate generally. Right? Because these groups, less crowded groups, are on the similar side in this. The E1 is the one which is minor. And this can be made major, in fact 97% of or more, by using this, by trapping it with dialkyl borate. Now this Z enolate, because boron oxygen bonds are shorter, so as a result these groups will come closer together. So with the result, if these groups, similar heavy groups, are on the same side, then they will tend to interact or crowd more. So by using this type of enolate, we can have Z enolate as the major compound, major enolate. Now this, when it will react, this enolate, when it will react with a carbonyl compound, what will happen? It will form two types of transition states. So these transition states are shown by this six-membered structure. This is R1CHO. This is the carbonyl which is undergoing the nucleophilic attack by this enol. Enol is R2R2H C double bond C O B R 2, and this is the substituent R3 which is attached at this position where the oxygen is on the same carbon, carbonyl carbon. This is R3. Now this type of a transition state, this is a six-membered, if we recollect our cyclohexane chemistry. And these models are called by a particular name, Zimmermann-Traxler model. So this is the Zimmermann-Traxler transition state. And as we can see, there is crowding here, because R3, this is R3, the group which is attached to this carbonyl carbon, this carbon, and R1, the aldehyde which is undergoing condensation with this, they are on the same side in this, and hence this is one position, 1, 2, 3. We know 1,3 diaxial is what? Cis. So due to this, it will lead to the formation of what type of a product? 1,3 diaxial is cis, but 1,2 diaxial is trans. So we will get an anti-product. So the anti-isomer will be formed. And on the other hand, this anti-isomer will again be having an enantiomer. Remember this. So on the other hand, if this is the case, that is, this is the transition state, because in the other transition state, R1 was here. It can also attack in this such a way that R1 is here. Now, in this case, we can see 1, 2, 3. 1, 3 cis is what? These H is cis to this alkyl group which is attached to carbonyl. So, the crowding is much, much reduced. So, this sort of a transition state, six-membered, will be prevalent, will be the major, and will give rise to sin. The sin product. Sin means this R2 and OH, they are now on the same side. We can correlate by using this, that since this, now this, this and this are on the same side, so this and this formed will also be on the same side. With, as a result, what will happen, that from the Z isomer, we will be getting the syn as the major product, as is clearly shown by means of this Zimmermann model, the transition state for the syn form being much less crowded, so being more stable, leading to syn as the major product. Now, in the case of the E enolate, this is the E enolate. In the case of E enolate, we can see here, this is E because the first priority, second priority. First priority, second priority. So similar priority groups are on opposite side. So this is E enolate. This, when it reacts with the carbonyl R1CHO, will again give rise to two types of transition states. So this is the Zimmermann-Traxler model, the six-membered state. And here we can see that R3 and H, they are on the cis side, same side, and crowding is not there. Now, 1, 3, this is cis, 1, 2, the H's, they are trans. In other words, the product also that we will get will be the anti or the trans product. So, the anti product is the major product if we consider the case of the E enolate. The E enolate forming here, the other transition state is also shown. In this case, as we can see, because R1 be, rather than being here, it can be that H is here and R1 is here. So in this case, what happens? There is crowding. And in this case, now this is, this will lead to the syn product. As we can see, the syn product, considering these H's, one axial, one equatorial. So this is syn, 1, 2. 1,3 diaxial is cis. Here, these two are cis. And here, this is equatorial, this is axial. So, this a syn product will be formed. Therefore, in an E enolate, the product which will be the major aldol will be the anti. Now, by using, as I've mentioned earlier, boron, the borates rather, so by trapping this while the hydrogen is being eliminated from here, that is while the enolate is being formed, then the Z-distereoisomer can be made to predominate. Why? We have, because we have selected this dialkyl boron triflate. So dialkyl boron triflate with this will tend to form this Z as the major product. The Z enolate will be the major rather than E. The Z one is the major. And when we know when the Z is the major, in that case, the syn product is the major aldol product. As a result of this, the syn will be the major one, which we will get. So this is, again, we can see this is Z, 1, 2. 1, 2. So similar priority groups on similar side. And we have used, how have we generated this enolate? We have generated it by using dialkyl boron triflate in the presence of base. Now, this syn is the major product. And in this case, as was shown earlier, this will be the minor product. In fact, this predominates to such an extent that this is around 97% of the syn product. So what have we done? Distereo selectivity. Since now syn is the major. Now remember, the syn will also have a mirror image. These are shown by the wedges. In the mirror image, these will be shown by the dashes. So it will have a pair of mirror image. Now we have done our selectivity till here, diastereoselectivity. Let's see if we can further move on to enantioselectivity. Now yes, we can do the enantioselectivity. How? That is, after diastereoselectivity, we are doing enantioselectivity. So this is called as double asymmetric synthesis. We have separated it once, and now we are out of those two, we are separating one of these. How can we do it? By using a chiral auxiliary. Chiral auxiliaries are simply, you know, units, chiral units, which are attached, with the help of which we can produce the, we can say, carbene ion, and this carbene ion can then react with an aldehyde to give us the product, and the attack will take place because we have selected syn. Now we have got the syn product. From the syn, out of those two enantioisomers, we will get one of the two enantioisomers, because supposing this is projecting from behind, if it is projecting from, it can, this group which is present here will be such that it will hinder the attack from one direction, this chiral, entire chiral group. So as a consequence, we will be getting the product attack from only, if it is in alpha, from beta, if it is in the beta position, from alpha. So as a result, what will happen, that this condensation will result in such a way that we will get only one of the two enantiomers. So this chiral auxiliary, now the work has been done by this chiral auxiliary. Auxiliary means later on it will be removed. It's done its work. So it has guided it, directed it, so that this attack takes place only from one side. And in that case, we get only one type of an enantiomer. And this, on hydrolysis, this will form then, see over here, this will leave this portion. It will be cleaved from here. And we will get over here OH. So we've got this acid. This acid can be reduced to get the aldehyde. Or different reagents can be used over here to get different types of products where the cleavage is being done. And the work of the auxiliary is being done. The chiral, this is chiral, having this big group. So as a result, we have done our double asymmetric synthesis and got only one enantiomer of the syn. Because syn will be having two, a pair of enantiomers. So we have done, in other words, enantioselectivity. That is double asymmetric synthesis. Now coming to the other aspect. What happens when the carbonyl is having two positions from where the alpha hydrogens can be abstracted as hydrogen positive? So carbene ion can be formed here or here. This is the case. Rather than having just one alpha, it has got two alpha. So we want one of the products to predominate. In other words, the attack can be from here or it can be from here. Of, because this is negative, carbonyl can attack here. If hydrogen leaves here, carbonyl can attack here. This will attack. So in other words, we can get two types of structural isomers. Then how to go about it so that we can control the reaction? That is, we are doing regioselectivity. So this is again a directed aldol condensation, because we as chemists are directing in which direction the reaction should go. Now in the presence of a base, carbene ion can be formed here or here. If it is formed here, we know this is the kinetically favored position, CH3, because it's not present in between, so it's present in one corner. So kinetically, this is the kinetic enolate. This kinetic enolate will lead to the formation of this type of a product, because CH2 will be attacked by this group, CH, at this position, because this is the carbene ion. So this is the kinetic product. But as we very well know, that the thermodynamic enolate is the one which is stable. Thermodynamic one, that is when the double bond is, when the hydrogen is migrated from here. So this is the carbene ion, which will stabilize. And these two carbons are the ones which are more substituted, the more substituted as compared to this. So this will be thermodynamically stable. So if this is the major product, in this case, the major enolate which is being formed, and in that case, what will happen? In that case, we will get this type of a product, that is CHO, the carbonyl positive carbon will attack it at this carbon rather than this carbon. So in that case, this will be the product that will be formed. This is the major product. Now, since this is the major product, but supposing we have some compound of interest which may be having some medicinal value, or some compound which we want to synthesize, where we do not want the thermodynamic one to be the major product. We want this to be the major product. So how do we go about it? In that case, where we want the attack at this kinetic position, kinetic enolate, this carbene ion, then a big base is selected, a sterically crowded base, such as LDA, lithium diisopropylamine, that is selected. And because it is heavy, so what will happen? It is big. This base is crowded, unlike the OH negative. So this will not be able to attack, because this position is a crowded position. So as it, because this will raise the energy of the system, so it will attack it at this position only. And we will get the kinetic enolate this time as the major enolate, leading to this product being the major product. So this is known as regioselectivity in aldol condensation by using regioselectivity, where there is a possibility of formation of a structural isomer. That is, the condensation can take place at this carbon, because this can be a carbene ion. At the same time, at this alpha carbon, this can also produce a carbene ion. So there is a possibility of two types of products being formed. And since the addition will take place, condensation will take place here, because this is more stable, so we will get the thermodynamic one as the stable product. But if we are desiring a kinetic product that is attack at this end, at this carbon, then in that case, a heavy base is used, a sterically crowded base, we use LDA or a bulky base. And since we are, controlling this reaction or selecting it out of these two, this has been now selected. Rather, this was the preferred pathway, but this was selected by using this type of a reagent. Our chemistry is being used. Therefore, it is called as a regioselective reaction. And again, since we are directing it, this is directed aldol condensation. Now, coming to the application part, this reaction which is generating carbon-carbon, new carbon-carbon bonds, a very simple and easy way to generate carbon-carbon bonds, is used, finds a wide application in enzymatic synthesis, in stereoselective synthesis of ephedrine, etc., in synthesis of ionophore antibiotics, in the manufacture of pharmaceuticals, in the synthesis of chalcones, which are belong to the polyphenolic family and have a number of properties such as antioxidant and anti-inflammatory, in plasticizers, for synthesizing plasticizers, in polymer chemistry, and for the synthesis of perfumes. One can refer to these works by R. O'Brady, Proceedings of Natural Academy Science, in the of the year 1958, and Heathcock et al., Journal of Organic Chemistry, 1980. Again, Heathcock, CH, in Comprehensive Organic Synthesis, in the year 1991, published by Pergamon Press. So, coming to the last part, that is the limitations. Limitations are such that because this is a reaction which goes in equilibrium, so in order to make the reaction go towards the product formation, continuously the products has to be should be removed, and at times this is managed by using Southlet. At the same time, as we know, because if we are doing cross aldol condensation, and if both the carbonyl compounds contain alpha position hydrogens, and both the carbonyl compounds are different, that is R1, R2, it can lead to a mixture of product, and this is, does not have any synthetic applications. So this was all for today. We did the mechanism of aldol condensation. We did the stereochemistry. We dealt with the regioselective aspect by using LDA or bulky bases, and saw to the applications of aldol condensations and its limitations. So good day to all.